Hey guys, so while I was recording my summer haul, I realised I do a lot of shopping that doesn't like come under the normal haul. I do a lot of non-cosmetic based shopping as well. So today is my first non-cosmetic based haul. So we're just gonna get stuck right in. This will take the normal like haul kind of layout, but won't feature a single piece of makeup or like anything like that at all. This is more kind of random stuff I've bought that reveals more about my character rather than just what makeup brands I like to buy. So here we go. I went to Cheltenham without an actual handbag. So one of the very first things I did was go to Primark and pick up a bag. Now this is then the bag that I'm going to be using all summer as my like regular handbag. As you can see, it's not actually very big, but it is just big enough to be functional. The next place I went to was Poundland, and I picked up a new like sleeve for my iPad, which just happens to fit exactly so in my handbag, so I was like, this is ideal. I also picked up two of these pouches, but I can now only find one, so I'm like, where's the other one? This one has got my tech in it, and I also picked up these from Poundland, and this is like a headphone splitter because we travelled a lot and I was sat next to a dude who was like, why don't we share music instead of both be like really antisocial and listen to our own music, why don't we listen to the same thing? And I was like, okay, alright, but we're going to need two headphones each, otherwise that's going to be weird. So we picked up a couple of these between us, and it meant we could both listen to the same thing, but both still be in our own little world, and they were great. Mine happened to come with, like, two jack adapters as well, which I used, kind of, I did a lot of sound mixing, but I didn't bring, like, proper sound mixing headphones with me. So I like used this guy to jack into the sound desk and then put my headphones in. So it turned out to be really useful. I thought they were going to be pointless, but best pound I've ever spent. Talking of tech and techie stuff, I picked up a new case for my phone in TK Maxx, and this one comes complete with a like little clippy, don't even know if you can see that, little stand. So when I'm watching my hours of YouTube, I don't have to like continually hold my phone. I can just carry on watching my shows, or if I'm like properly reclined, because that's at a totally different angle now. It's like, stand up, lie down, stand up. Okay, I'm gonna stop before I break it. That was the other reason I picked up a new like double shockproof case for my phone. I was having like the most klutzy day ever. I spilt my coffee twice and then was just like throwing water all over the place. I like elbowed a colleague, so I was like, I'm getting a new case for my phone just in case I drop it. And I happened to drop my phone very quickly after putting the case on, so I was like, bad day for me. I went to the Apple store and picked up a new pair of Apple headphones. My other ones had like actually died. They'd frayed in all sorts of places, and I was listening to music with exposed wires, so I was like, headphones are going to be necessary on all the coach journeys. So, you know, I trust Apple. The next place I went to was a little kind of, it looked like an independent shop, but could probably be a chain shop in another country, and it's called Tink. Yep, Tink. And it's kind of strange things. So what I picked up was a like portable speaker. Only the weird thing that this does is it doesn't rely on wires or Wi-Fi or Bluetooth or anything like that to connect. It just relies on the power of magnets. So all you do is, I'm sorry if I seem uninterested, but I'm not listening. And then you just I just came to kick it. Which is just kind of really cool. I hadn't realised we got to the point where you could do it with magnets. Which kind of gives it a degree of just being able to be like really easily plug and played. You can just, you don't even have to plug, you can just play. So you can just sit it on the grass and everybody can just boop, 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 boop. My turn to play a song. So that was really useful while I was in Jonah. Last place I went was WH Smith's, and I am a bit of a book worm, and I hadn't read a full book in quite a long time. So I walked in with the intention of picking up a new book, and so I picked up The Death Collector. Now this is a book by Neil White, and it is about a criminal defence lawyer and his brother, who are a police. He's a police detective up in Manchester, and they have to track down a serial killer, in essence, but, you know, it's never as easy as it seems. I am not very far through the book. I'm here. So, you know, I've got a lot of reading to do. I didn't really find time to do any reading, but hopefully, now I'm a bit more relaxed, I'll actually get through it. Because it's a good book so far. The Death Collector's killed his first person, so I'm all sorts of excited. The last three things sort of that I picked up are kind of a way to alleviate stress, so don't judge me. I picked up an adult colouring book. Basically, I was very wound up, kind of stress-wise while we were there, and the kids were colouring, and one day I was like, I'm going to do some colouring with the kids, and it properly calmed me down. I was de-stressed. And so I picked up a colouring book and then realised I had no actual felt tips to colour in with. So I picked up a set of the Stadlia colouring pens and then realised they didn't have a purple. And purple is my favourite colour. So I was need to correct that. So I had to go back and pick up a single purple pen. Yeah. Don't ask. I needed a purple. So I now have a complete set of colouring pens and a colouring book. And I'm not going to lie, this guy then went everywhere with me. It was in the bottom of my handbag. This handbag. For 6 weeks. And any time I got kind of stressed while we were out on excursion, I would just sit down and colour. So there are lots of kind of photos of me from the camp, with my headphones in, listening to music, colouring, I'm so stressed! And you can kind of physically see me calm down, I'm okay now. And that is the end of what I bought while I was at summer camp. I feel like these are a kind of a better way to get to know someone than the these are the cosmetics I bought. Because if I hadn't done this, you would never have known about the colouring obsession. Or the crime novel obsession. So, yeah. I have lots of things in the pipeline for you guys that I'm kind of really excited about. So, I'm going to get on and plan them and see you next time.